You know where we're headed?
Yep.
Okay, good.
We're out here in the middle of the night to find the bottles that William Beal buried 140 years ago in the longest running plant biology experiment.
Way back in 1879, Professor William James Beal, a botanist here at Michigan State University, set up an experiment to answer a basic scientific question. He wanted to know, how long do seeds survive in the soil?
We keep it secret so that people don't know where the bottles are to keep them safe underground, and so that the other seeds aren't exposed to light.
We don't want any light to shine down on them and accidentally start germinating the seeds from the bottles that we might want to be digging up 20, 40, or 60 years from now.
It's gonna be right about here somewhere.
That's where we're at, right here.
Ta-da!
Right?
Right.
So I think the vault's actually going that way.
Okay, so that's the vault. It's right there.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh!
What's that?
Uh-oh. I think I found it.
You did?
Yeah. It was a rock.
Oh.
Seriously?
Yeah, I'm serious. I'm sorry.
I think it's just so cool. Get to witness history.
Okay, now I for real found it.
You did?
Yeah. Whew. Yeah, I definitely did. Yeah, look at that.
There's a glass jar there?
There's a glass jar.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Hello, bottles.
All right. Oh, all right, team.
Bum, bum, bum.
Oh, don't spill it.
There it is.
Seriously.
Wow. There it is.
Yeah.
All right. Good job.
We'll now take this over to plant bio, take the rest of the mix and put it into a tray and put it in the growth chamber and see what germinates. And in 7 to 10 days, we should start seeing results if anything's viable in this.
I'm doing something that no one has done before, which is try and find some of the seeds that are in the sand before they go into the germination assay. And what I would like to do with these seeds that I find is take out their nucleic acids. With these newer molecular methods, we can sort of quantify how far away the seed is from being alive. Is it just a little dead? Is it really dead?
Found one!
We are bringing cutting-edge resources to this experiment that Beal could not have even imagined existing. They didn't even know about DNA when he was burying these seeds.
We all benefit from this. We all gain our collective knowledge, whether it's in medicine or whether it's in biology, plant biology and agriculture, you know, whether it's in space exploration, whatever it happens to be, we all benefit from the technology, the science that we learn.
The people who put the bottle in the ground probably wouldn't have imagined somebody like me or somebody like Margaret being involved in the team. It's a really neat symbolic moment for women in science.
I think I selected, you know, some really good team members to be involved, excellent group of scientists.
I'll be thrilled if things come up, but then I'd also be thrilled if nothing came up too, because that would also be a result. And it's possible that even if we get no germination this year, we could have some species germinating in 2040. So we would very much want to know that.
And they will be able to take it on to 2040 and pass it on to the next generation for 2060 and 2080 and on up to 2100.
141 years later, almost 142 years, there's something germinating in the Beal Seed Experiment. This is, oh my gosh, I didn't expect to see anything today. This is, wow.
The fact that something actually germinated and we can watch those 142-year-old plants grow is really, really exciting. Beal would be smiling. He would be smiling from ear to ear. He would just be, wow, who knew? This is incredible. This is fantastic. And that's the way we all feel about it. And I can't imagine that Professor Beal wouldn't feel the same way.